Good morning, everybody. Welcome to today's Healing Minute from the virtual Harry Edwards Healing Sanctuary. Healing blessings wherever you are, and whether you're watching live or on catch up, please remember our motto: wherever you are, we are here for you. I'm John, speaking to you as always from Hillingdon, West London. And I will warn you that in case we get an aircraft coming over the top and a loud noise occurs, please don't be worried. It's only landing or taking off from Northolt Airport. The music in the background is by Aeolia, and the CD is entitled Angel Love, and the track is Celestial Sanctity. But thank you for joining us today for the Healing Minute. This session, as always, includes an opportunity for each of us to send healing to the people and animals we know are in need. Today's reading is about forgiveness, with a little input from Harry Edwards. And the finishing music is about my own forgiveness of myself and others. But I'm going to turn the music down now as we begin to prepare by relaxing for the Healing Minute. In preparation, please close your eyes if it's safe to do so. And in your own mind, take yourself off to your own personal sanctuary, somewhere that you feel perfectly safe, totally at ease, and completely peaceful. Take a deep breath in and inhale the healing energy and allow it to flow through your body from the top of your head to the tips of your toes. As you breathe out, let go of all your personal stresses and any dis-ease in your daily life. We now begin to attune with spirit so that we may connect with the higher source to send the healing messages. We give thanks that we're gathered here today. We ask that this place be filled with love, light, friendship, and healing energies. We surround ourselves in protection as we open our hearts and expand our consciousness to allow the flow of love and healing to come through us. As our crown chakra opens, we visualize a column of pure white light coming down and filling our body. And then feel the balance and harmony within our body as the earth energy rises up through the soles of our feet and our base chakra. We truly feel our connection to the universal source of pure, unconditional love, balanced by the nurturing, protective love of Mother Earth. I'm going to read now the Harry Edwards prayer, which I've read many times before and I'm sure lots of you are familiar with, but it always rings a chord. May I be thankful for the blessings I already have. Grant me relief from pain and sickness. Protect me from all ills and grant me good health in the days to come. Remove all causes of imperfection and bring your healing ministers close to me, that I may be conscious of their presence and so receive guidance and inspiration. Grant me courage and fortitude to overcome all adversity. Let me be conscious of your strength in all times of need. Grant me confidence to overcome my fears and not anticipate harm. Teach me how to live rightly in your sight, to do only that which is right and true. I pray that good guidance and right influencing will inspire all your peoples to be as brothers, one to the other, and that peace shall endure for all time. Amen. Just going to read Touched by Angels, which is a nice little poem introduced to me by our dear friend Alan. We are touched by angels and walk where angels tread. They will guide us, walk beside us through the days ahead. In the hours of darkness, when our dreams are flown, they bring hope and gentle healing. We are not alone. In our times of doubting, still they understand, and forever touched by angels, we walk hand in hand. And now the great invocation. From the point of light within the mind of God, let light stream forth into human minds. Let light descend on earth. From the point of love within the heart of God, let love stream forth into human hearts. May the coming one return to earth. From the centre where the will of God is known, let purpose guide all little human wills for the purpose which the masters know and serve. From the centre which we call the human race, let the plan of love and light work out, and may it seal the door where evil dwells. Let light and love and power restore the plan on earth. We ask now that all the people whose names we hold in the distant healing folder may receive healing for their highest good. We also request healing for their family, friends, and the people who have requested distant healing. May they be placed in the healing light and receive that which they are allowed to receive for their highest good. So let's take a minute and send out the healing love. Thank you. Our thanks and blessings for your help today, and to our friends in spirit. I've inserted a donate button on this page so that if you can afford and you feel that you have benefited from healing from the sanctuary, you can send a little money to help our charity carry on. But now I want to talk about forgiveness. And one of the things I'm very mindful of is that forgiveness is not forgetfulness. And that because a forgiveness is given, either to ourselves or to others, it doesn't mean we have to forget the situation around it. And I know I have a number of forgiveness demons in my life. And I was drawn to this Buddhist prayer of forgiveness, which on Facebook was posted by Alderney Serenity. I don't know who they are, but I want to thank them now. And I'm going to read it to you because it opens a whole new aspect to this. And it goes, "If I have harmed anyone in any way, either knowingly or unknowingly, through my own confusions, I ask their forgiveness. If anyone has harmed me in any way, either knowingly or unknowingly, through their own confusions, I forgive them. And if there is a situation I am not yet ready to forgive, I forgive myself for that, for all the ways that I harm myself, negate, doubt, belittle myself, judge, or be unkind to myself, through our own confusions, I forgive myself. There is no doubt that we are our own worst critics, without any shadow of doubt. And thinking of forgiveness, which perhaps is a bit, as Harry Edwards would have seen it, as cleansing the soul, I'm now going to read an article from The Healer magazine, February 2012, which Harry first wrote in 1962, or was first published in 1962, about how healing can not only help physical ills, but also a means of cleansing the soul. The question is sometimes asked, why is it that sometimes good people are not healed, while others, who are less charitable to their fellow man, are enabled to recover from their afflictions? This is not a question to which one can give a categorical answer, but there are some considerations to merit careful thought. We know that the primary motive that lies behind healing is not so much the overcoming of disease, but to demonstrate that we are all akin to spirit, having a divine heritage to enjoy when the earthly phase of life has terminated. This is an appeal to reason, for it is obvious that no one can receive benefit from a higher source unless they are in tune with it. This does not imply that those who do not seem to respond are not attuned spiritually, for there are other factors which must be considered. For example, it should be remembered that healing is not all-powerful. It cannot override the basic laws that govern life. Yet much can be done within the framework of those laws, as the many healings testify. Sometimes the cause of a trouble is perpetuated even unknowingly, especially when it is deeply seated in the subconscious frustration. We have so often seen that through healing the minds of those who have been strongly materialistic and even cruel, have been changed into a more happy and more enlightened outlook. Personalities have been changed to enable the overcoming of vices. Let us assume the instance of a man whose conduct is said to be ungodly, but who is suffering from acute distress from a disease, or for which the doctors say they cannot do more. He hears about spiritual healing and in his desperation seeks its help. As he does so, he enters into a spiritual atmosphere and his thoughts are turned towards receiving help from a higher source. In this way, he obtains not only healing for his physical affliction, but for his soul too. And thus his spiritual consciousness is reborn. So when a person feels upset in seeing one who was not living a good life respond to the healing, while a dear one may not, then he or she should remember that possibly the person is being transformed, thus entering into a life of serenity and service to others. This is not a daydream, for we have in our experience so often seen these good changes take place. Healing does not depend upon God overriding his laws that govern us in favourable discrimination for a particular person. It does not depend on the patient's faith or spirituality. Although these qualities are so helpful in cooperating with the spirit endeavour, healing depends upon reaching and overcoming the cause of the disease and mastering the symptom within the system of things. Healing is not denied to anyone, and if it is the means of cleansing a man's or woman's soul, as well as overcoming physical affliction, then the healing is all the more worthwhile. The healer must never be a discriminator, deciding for whom he should seek healing. He is not the judge of whether a person is worthy of healing or not. It is the healer's task ever to seek the aid of spiritual healing. Wherever there is pain and sickness, whether the sufferer be good or bad, whether he is prince or a beggar, a Christian or a Mohammedan, or even an agnostic, the way of redemption is to be found through the spiritual implications that arise from the way of the healing, whether it be for man or child or woman or the human family as a whole. Harry, as always, is extremely insightful. It is no doubt that learning to forgive is like cleansing the soul. And we are, I repeat, our own worst critics. So let's move on to parish notices. There is no Cygnus Cafe during August. Linda and the crew are taking a break, but they will be back, re-enlivened in September, I am assured. On Sunday the 22nd of August, at 7:30 p.m. we have a guided meditation by Lyndall DeMere, all the way from her sunny home in California, USA. And tomorrow's Healing Minute will be given by Stuart, and on Sunday, our dear friend Dory. As always, all these talks and events are recorded, unless specifically excluded, of course, and you can get those links from the Harry Edwards website. So thank you so much for spending your valuable time with us for the benefit of others today. Anyone who has received healing in any source from the sanctuary will be on the distant healing list for a month. Do keep us informed, as contact is always good. The sanctuary is open for contact healing under COVID secure situations. And also we have our big day, our 75th anniversary of the sanctuary, on the 4th of September, where Alan will do a Zoom from the actual grounds, which will be super. But now I'm going to move on to some music. And this is by a gentleman I haven't seen live, sadly, a guy called Mike Summerfield. No, Mike Rutherford. I always get them mixed up. From Mike and the Mechanics. And it's entitled The Living Years. The words mean a lot to me.
We don't see eye to eye.
Thank you, everybody, for being with us this morning. Stay safe and healthy, and I'll be back on the 3rd of September. Bye.